So this fight we're in, I'm in, will always be for me. I always envisage it as an uphill thing.
Yes.
You know, like as if you were trying to go the wrong way up an escalator. It's always going to be an exhausting thing.
That's right.
But you do it and living in the hope that one day great things will happen and people will truly wake up and rise up. And I think there are signs of that. So there are signs of that with Trump and 64 million Americans that made that happen against all the odds.
Absolutely.
There are signs of that with Brexit and now with Boris Johnson, because people who had voted Labour, the left, Bernie Sanders, all their lives, came out on that one day and they voted for Boris Johnson, even though they hated Conservatives, hated everything that the Conservatives stand for. They did it because it was right for the country. And I wonder, as we now reach in the UK a critical time where people really, it's becoming very obvious that we are rapidly a minority.
Yes.
Will that moment come where people do say, we cannot go on like this? I don't know. It's in the hands of the gods or the God, but I certainly know that you and I both continue on the uphill fight.
Yes.
In the belief that hope will come.
I was watching 60 Minutes here and, last Sunday, and they did a story on Hungary. And in Hungary, they are motivating white people there to have babies, to get married and have families. And they are refusing to let all these whatever folks they are, illegal aliens, yes, aliens come into the country. And I was like, right on. About time some white people stood up somewhere, and you had other people calling it racist. They said he was a supremacist. And I'm like, these people are dumb. Let them say what they want. You got to do what's right at some point. And I'm very happy to see Hungary doing that.
Oh, it's so exciting. I was just trying to squiggle a terrible, terrible diagram that we aren't going to be able to see very well. But my point rather being is that if this is Great Britain, and so this is the coastline of Europe, and this would be Italy, and this is Europe here.
Yeah.
Europe is utterly, you know, delusional and lost. You've got Germany and Merkel inviting all the migrants, ridiculous Spain, socialists, but Hungary, Poland, those countries here, they are working together. The Visegrad Group, it's called. They are Eastern European countries, and they, and it looks almost like a heart shape when you look at it on a map. That will be the place that people retreat to, and that's where the new crusades will come one day. If we have to retreat to a space, we,
yes,
will retreat to Poland, to Hungary, because they have no illegal immigration. They have not allowed a single mosque to be built. They patrol their borders, and it is the safest place in Europe to be a female or for a girl to grow up, because they have no terrorism and no crime of that nature.
Beautiful.
So that will be the place that we return to. If we ever need to retreat to defendable space, it will be Poland and Hungary. You're absolutely right.
Amazing. I'm glad to hear that. Yeah. One other thing about how the white girls are being raped and, you know, killed over there. Can you imagine what would happen if white guys were doing that to the Muslims or to the blacks or to any other race? They would haul all the white people in, put them on a train, and get rid of them. But because it's happening to white girls by Muslims and others, no one seemed to care. Oh, just another white girl raped.
That's right. And because we have been schooled in the thought that you do not criticize someone who has a different color skin, you do not criticize someone who believes in Islam, you do not criticize the Muslim individual who did this. You know, these white girls, when they were going to police stations to say what had happened to them, that 20 men or so had used them and passed them around, whatever, those white girls were turned away.
Wow.
And told that they'd been making these things up, that they were just, it was a story. They were turned away by the people that should help them, because the police did not want to be called racist. They didn't want to risk that they would lose their chance of promotion by being the one who was involved with this nasty little matter. And so that's what we have. And we still have those majority Pakistani Muslim rape squads in operation up and down the country here. And it's still a real difficulty. You know, if you do speak of it, as we saw with Tommy Robinson, it's an imprisonable offence because, you know, just as we didn't take Asia Bibi, the lady that was looking for refuge from Pakistan, we didn't take her in the UK, even though she applied because the government said it might upset local communities.
That's
and by local communities, they mean the majority Muslim population that we have coming here.
That's, you know, I've said for a long time now that our battle is a spiritual battle. It's a warfare between good and evil. And that is a perfect example of evil at work. And because the children of God won't stand up and say no to it, evil is winning. But there's hope. We just mentioned Hungary and other places. There's hope there in America. There are Mexicans and blacks and whites and others who are starting to wake up. So there's hope. It's not over. It's not over until the fat lady sings.
That is right. There is hope. And I always feel there's joy, you know, and it's one of the great things. I spend a lot of time in California talking to secret conservatives. There's so many conservatives in California. And it's one of the things I always come away from meetings and events and being on the sidewalk in America. There's so much joy.
Yes.
And there's so much joy when we're together, because it feels uplifting to be fighting for what we know is good and proper. And we just want everyone to do brilliantly well. That's all it is. That's what it comes down to. We want everybody to live their best life. And if you are the person involved with that, you know, it can't be wrong, and the battle can never be too hard, because it's always going to be for the right reasons.
That's right.